Hi, everyone. Welcome to another episode of the Google Ads Developer Series on authentication. I'm Laura, and I'm a developer relations engineer on the Google Ads API. In this episode, I'll be demonstrating how to set up a cloud project to generate an OAuth client ID and client secret for a web application, and then use the OAuth playground to retrieve refresh and access tokens. OAuth 2 credentials are needed to access the Google Ads API regardless, but the process I'll be showing you is most useful for users who only need to access the accounts for a single manager account or Google Ads user. If you need to retrieve refresh tokens for multiple users, stay tuned for a future episode on configuring client libraries for OAuth. Before we dive in, here's an overview of what we'll be doing. First, we'll create a Google Cloud project. Then we'll use our cloud project to generate a client ID and client secret. Once we have those credentials, we'll head over to the OAuth Playground, which is a tool Google provides to manually generate API tokens. Once we have our tokens, we'll run a code example to test that we can successfully authenticate with OAuth. You can find instructions on how to do all of this in the developer documentation, which I've also linked in the video description, so reference that as an additional resource. I'll walk step by step through the same setup process, and I'll explain the gotchas along the way. We're going to go straight to the cloud console, so that's console.cloud.google.com. And for demonstration purposes, I'm going to create a new project. So we'll just call this my project. And I will give my project a location. The location is just the folder within my organization where I want to store this project. Not all GCP accounts have organizations. These typically represent a company and are the root nodes in the Google Cloud resource hierarchy. Once I've selected my location, I'll click Create. And we'll just wait for that project to be available so that we can switch into it and use it to create our credentials. All right, so we've selected our project. Now we're in our dashboard and we need to head to APIs and services and then credentials. So you can see here, it's giving us a warning that we need to configure our OAuth consent screen. This is needed before we can actually set up our client ID. So we're going to do this first. There are some help articles available on the right if you want to read more about what the consent screen is for. But in short, the consent screen is shown to the user for whom this project will access the Google Ads API. They must agree that your app can manage AdWords campaigns on your behalf. Okay, for my purposes, I'm going to select external users as my user type. This means that my project will be available to users outside of my organization. If I were to select internal users, I would be limiting my app to authorization requests for members of my organization. You'll see the consent screen in practice later on in the demo when we use the OAuth Playground to generate tokens. App name, I'll just call this my app. I will give my email as the support email. I don't need any of these app domains for my app, so I'll just fill out this developer contact information with my own email. Okay, and now it's asking us to add or remove scopes. Scopes are the permissions our app will request from the user. In our case, we need to request permission to access the Google Ads API and manage campaigns on behalf of the authenticating user. I actually don't need to give any scopes right now because I'm going to come back to this in the OAuth Playground. So I'm going to save and continue for now. And this is just for demo purposes, so I won't add any test users either. All right, this summary looks good, so I'll head back to my dashboard. And we'll move on to our credentials setup. So I'll go to credentials again, create credentials. We want to create an OAuth client ID. And this again is one of the credentials that's necessary to access the Google Ads API. For this demo, we'll be creating credentials for a web application. Have a look at the introduction episode of the series if you want an explanation on when you might configure a web application versus a desktop app, for instance. And these are the two different types that you can use for the Google Ads API. We can leave the authorized JavaScript origins blank because our app isn't actually a client-side web application. And then under authorized redirect URIs, which are the endpoints that the OAuth 2.0 server will send responses to, we will need to put https://developers.google.com/OAuthPlayground. This is only needed for now so that we can use the OAuth Playground to generate a refresh token. Once you have that, you can actually remove this from the list of authorized redirect URIs. And you can find this URL in the documentation as well. It's not something you need to know off the top of your head. So click Create, and now we have our client ID and client secret. Let's note these down so that we have them easily accessible for the next piece, which is to use the OAuth Playground to generate our access and refresh tokens. Don't worry if you already exited out without noting them down, though, since these will always be available to you through the console's credentials page. So if I just go download OAuth client, you can see them again. Okay, now with our new credentials, we'll head to the OAuth Playground using the link that's found in the description or in our developer docs. And that will pre-populate some values for us. So I'm going to use the one in this OAuth Playground documentation. Now you can see it's already pre-populated some of this configuration for us. Now in these settings in the corner, we want to confirm a few things. First, we'll make sure the Use Your Own OAuth Credentials box is checked, so we're good on that. We also need to make sure that our access type is offline, which it is. That makes it so that we get back a refresh token and access token instead of just an access token. And we'll also make sure that the OAuth flow is set to server side. Now with all that checked out, we can plug in our client ID and client secret from before. So I'll go back and copy those over. Client ID and client secret. Okay, now we want to select, this is the scopes piece that I was referencing earlier. So in our case, the scope that we need is this AdWords scope, which is also pre-populated by that link. So we'll click Authorize APIs now that we've got all that set up. And it's going to ask us to authenticate. This is the OAuth consent screen that we configured earlier. Because I allowed external users, I could also complete this step with a Google user outside of my organization, and that would generate access and refresh tokens for that user, which could be used alongside the client ID and client secret we generated earlier. Okay, as expected, it's asking to manage my AdWords campaigns, so I'll allow that. Okay, and now I've got this authorization code, which I can exchange for tokens. So I'm going to go ahead and click Exchange Authorization Code for Tokens. There we go. All right, and it's already giving a countdown for when our access token will be unavailable, but if we're using the client libraries, we'll be able to use our refresh token to generate a new access token. So if we're using a client library, we can copy that refresh token into the config file for our library, along with that client ID and client secret values. We could also make a curl request by passing the access token in the authorization header, but note that as I mentioned, the refresh tokens are long-lived and the access tokens expire in an hour. So this is maybe good for testing, but not great for production. For the purposes of this demo, we'll be testing our credentials using a client library, specifically the Python client library, but every client library requires the same configuration values, just differently formatted. Also note that in order for this to work, a user with permissions on the advertiser or the manager account should be used to generate the OAuth tokens. So in my case, the email that I used is on the manager account of the accounts that I want to access. All right, let's recap real quick. We first created a cloud project that enabled the Google Ads API. Using the OAuth playground with the cloud project's client ID and client secret, we then created a refresh token. The refresh token authenticates us as a specific user to a specific ads account. We can repeat the refresh token generation for another user on another account using the same client ID and secret. That way, one cloud project can manage many ads accounts. All right, now with that all squared away, let's get straight into the demo. Okay, so I've left some open spaces here for my client ID, client secret, and refresh token. So I'll go back. I'll just pull it directly from where I pasted it in the OAuth playground. Client secret. And the refresh token that I got back from the playground. All right, and now that I have those values set, I'm gonna go ahead and run one of my examples. All right, so I've got all my credentials set up that I just got from my new project. I have my developer token, which I previously generated through my manager account, which doesn't have to be generated through the same account that you use to generate the refresh token or the client ID and secret. Okay, well, this is interesting. So we're getting an error, permission denied. Google Ads API has not been used in that project before, or it is disabled. Enable it by visiting, okay. So it's giving us this URL. Let's go back and plug that in. All right, and so now we've enabled the Google Ads API. Let me go back and retry. Okay, and that worked. And that's it. So we've fully configured OAuth 2 for our web app. Thanks everyone for joining.